Hello, gorgeous seekers, and welcome to Moon Magic. I am so excited to sit down with this refreshing, experimental, open, expansive new moon in Aquarius at 15 degrees of Aquarius on February 4th, 2019. This moon is just a really great refresher, reconnector after we've had some of the eclipse action and we've had some of these heavier aspected moons that were really not letting us off the hook with what we were needing to look at. This is a moon I think we really need after that Leo lunar eclipse that we had. And those of you who have been following me for a while know that I have a deep and profound love for Aquarian energy. It's something that lights me up in a very specific way. So I always am appreciative of the new and the full moons in Aquarius. And this one is really one of those ones where we don't have harsh aspects. We don't have harsh conversations. We don't have these kind of homework assignment energies. And that's what I really want you to take away as you think about this moon. New moons are already one of my favorite things. There's something so soft and creative and inventive and gentle about them that you can really just use in the quiet of yourself to magnify everything you want. So let's talk about why this moon is so great and why I'm such a huge fan. Of course, Aquarian energy is known for its analytical abilities, its ability to communicate ideas, to communicate across various platforms, and to be very expansive. It's so much about the collective, and it has that air quality of deep, profound communication and the ability to see it from a bird's eye view, right? But it's interesting because this Aquarian new moon isn't asking us to analyze. It isn't asking us to get in there and find all the details. It's asking us to dive into the aspect of Aquarian energy, which is expansive, which is a little bit less about the nitpicking and is a little bit more about the giant picture. And there's a lot of reasons for that. So we have the sun and moon conjunct at 15 degrees of Aquarius, which is beautiful. That's what makes that new moon aspect. And it's very like right in the heart of Aquarian energy, right? It's right at the center of Aquarius season. It's a beautiful placement there. This moon is sextiling Jupiter in Sagittarius at 18 degrees of Sagittarius. It's a looser aspect. However, you know, Jupiter is such a benefic planet, and Sag and Aqua energies are very compatible. There is, because both are about the big picture, both are about very big philosophical ideas, and both are very much about how we can expand into new versions of things. So this is just a beautiful combo, two of my favorites, and Jupiter's home at Sagittarius, and we have this new moon. So these two are in this beautiful sextile conversation. And what they're really telling us to do here is to let ourselves feel positive about where we're expanding into. Let ourselves feel that we are allowed to open ourselves up to what is next. That we are allowed to start deep conversations, to start big projects. And actually, Mercury is at 19 degrees of Aquarius, while Jupiter is 18 degrees of Sagittarius. So those two are in a very close trine. And that's even more so. Mercury is fast and quick and wants to, you know, it's the short-term plans. Jupiter's all about the big-term plans, but they're having a conversation just saying like, let's let this energy flow. It's really beautiful. It's very simple. It's a very simple energy. It wants you to release. Now we have this other sextile that's going on that's also amazing, and it's kind of a wild one actually, because it's Saturn at 15 degrees of Capricorn and Neptune at 15 degrees of Pisces. So this is a beautiful sextile, Capricorn, Pisces. They have an interesting relationship, but these two planets, Saturn and Neptune, are at home, and they're doing a perfect sextile in their home signs. And they're very different energies, right? Neptune is all about expansiveness, dreaminess, fantasy. It's so much about ascension. It's not about being grounded in the physical. Whereas Saturn is so much about the real world, so much about how we can make our dreams come to fruition, how we can embody ourselves, how we can have our feet on the ground, how we can really show up because we are in these physical bodies. So the two really speak to two very different aspects of our existence as beings, right? One's very spiritual and mystical. One is also spiritual and mystical, but but wants us to channel it through the fact that we are in physical bodies. But because they're sextiling in this very positive fashion in their home signs like this, means that we are having a conversation about how we can let those dreamy, fantastical parts of ourselves come through us and be embodied in our physical. And that kind of healthy conversation between the two can really allow for deep healing, for deep acceptance of where we are in our life's path, and a little bit of that excitement about the fact that we can channel our fantastical visions into our physical, and that the two are actually always in dialogue. It's a great reminder of that. So you can see how this is so beautiful. We have so much home planet energy at home in these signs. Jupiter, Saturn, Neptune, it's gorgeous. And they're all hanging and having this nice, beautiful sextile party. And there's something to that. There's really something to that kind of flowing energy. It really holds a soft spot for all of us to allow ourselves to get dreamy and not punish ourselves for it, not try to get the how to get the when, how to get the technical aspects of it. In fact, the note I have for this moon, as we've been talking about these beautiful sextiles, is that the question in this new moon isn't what you're trying to let go of, what you're trying to dismantle, not what you're trying to say, oh, I've had a wall up about this for years, or this is my fortress, and acknowledging that. Sometimes we have those where we hit up against a hard wall. We have squares, or we have oppositions where we have to really get real about something that we're holding. This moon is not about that at all. In fact, the questions you should be asking yourself are these. What can I embrace about myself, about my imagination, about what I've been dreaming of doing, about who I can become? What do I want to open to? How do I let my body and my soul relax and completely trust into the next thing? How can I let it relax that just that little millimeter more? You know, have you ever done a body check-in where you're in the middle of your day? You're driving, you're talking on the phone, you're going to meetings, you're going to appointments. Believe me, I have these days all the time. I've had a really busy schedule and calendar recently. It's been a little wild. And you know, you check in with your body and you realize you've been holding your shoulders really tense, or you've been holding your jaw really tense, or even, you know, your stomach really tense. And you take a breath and you realize you release it. That's the kind of energy here. We want to just, even though I just said don't think about what you have to release, but it's like, how can you relax into it more? How can you lean into it more with that relaxed state? This is really a moon where we practice receptive mode in a very simple way. Once again, this is not a moon where we need to go and we need to journal. We need to bullet point everything we want and how we want that to look and how it's supposed to form and all the details of it and get really, really nitpicky with our manifestation. This is not a moon for that. This is a new moon where you kind of let go of those reins a little bit, right? And get into the bigger picture. Once again, Sag and Aqua energy are big picture energies, and they want you to take a step out of the nitpicky, take a step out of the day-to-day, take a step out of the super micro or the middle management lens, as I like to call it, and just float a little bit. Really, honestly, all these energies and the way they're talking, it's like, it's time to float. And it's interesting that Saturn's in the conversation, right? Because he's not known for being the guy who's like, let's float. He's Father Time. He's Father Structure. He's the planet of restriction. He wants to figure out how we're going to get it done. However, there's something about him being in the conversation the way that he is, where it's like the logic of Saturn also is that if you care for yourself and you release tension and you understand your inherent value, then you're able to move through the world in that Saturnian way that is much more efficient, right? I think a lot of times we think we need to buckle down, we need to do our spiritual homework, we need to really utilize these cycles and make sure we're checking in and doing all the homework. And sometimes we get our heads in this space where it feels like we need to be holding tension in order to be doing hard enough work. And that's not just in the day-to-day driving here and there, going to the meetings, getting the money, doing the work. It's also in how we treat ourselves when we're thinking about our emotional and our intuitive and our mental processes and how we think of ourselves and how we think of our work ethic within that. Saturn is being put in the context of this bigger thing, and he's actually game for that. Often he just has to come in when we're doing other more self-sabotagey things. However, I'm getting off topic because the point being, this is a moon where be open to what comes in and just let yourself daydream. Let yourself go into those fantastical spots. Not asking how. Don't ask how. Don't start daydreaming about, oh, I would love it if I was living in that location. But how would I ever do that? Don't go there. Just say, ooh, living in that other location. Yeah. Or, you know, ooh, having that love relationship. Yeah, just let yourself have the fantasy. Let yourself have it. Lean into it. Breathe into it. Let yourself wash through these expansive energies, because if you can trust yourself to let yourself even go into fantasy zone, and you don't ask how and why constantly, and you don't expect it to show up on your doorstep the next morning, it actually will show up in easier ways. So like I said, this is a great moon to practice receptive mode, which means to release, it means to stop holding tension and to lean into the relaxation. Let's pull some cards. Like I said, this moon has this crisp, fresh, clean, chilled out vibe. I'm loving it. I am so appreciative of that because, okay, a card just like flew far, far away from me. And it's Judgment. Which is interesting because you know how I was saying that this moon is not about what you're supposed to be. You're not supposed to be focusing on like old barriers or what you're releasing. You're supposed to be focusing more on like what you're leaning into. But this is a dualistic energy, right? It's very tied to Pluto, who is also in Capricorn, but not really in a tight aspect to anybody right now. However, you know, Pluto is a very profound healing energy. And one aspect of Pluto is, yes, the death, the release, the tearing down old walls, the destruction. But the other part of that Pluto energy is also the opening up. And one thing with the Judgment energy is a lot of people can't connect with this energy so much, but it is about letting yourself, okay, all this wild stuff has happened, sure. We've died, we've lost our identities, we've done all this stuff, and yet we can open ourselves to the grace of the divine at any point, any time. We can open ourselves to allow for that beautiful, graceful, divine energy to come meet us. So as that card was flying out, I was about to say that the Leo lunar eclipse, that whole like few days around that was just wild for me. Was anybody else just having very profound experiences that were really showing a sharp relief? Some things I didn't actually expect some of the stuff to happen that did happen, but it was really magical. A lot of amazing things happened within all of that. So it was just, I'm excited just for this moon that lets us be expansive, lets us be kind of put our toes into this next energetic phase now that we've closed out the Leo and Aquarius eclipse season. This is one of the first moons we're having where we are no longer, it's the first Aquarius moon that we're having where we're no longer with Aquarius South Node. And so it's just even within that, if you don't even look at the other aspects that have been shifting over, this is a moon that's just very much about a new phase. So it's like we're dipping our toes into a new energetic landscape, and we need to let ourselves do that. We need to let ourselves trust into it. Five of Swords. Right. As I said, trust into it, what came in, but Five of Swords, which is a lack of trust. Whether that because you feel you can't trust other people, because you feel people are doing things behind your back or doing sneaky things or sneaking around or what have you. Five of Swords often, and I think this came up in a moon not that long ago, and I was talking about how if we don't trust ourselves to make choices and set healthy boundaries for ourselves, we often start to live life feeling like we're in this Five of Swords mode where we have to second guess other people's ulterior motives because we don't have that internal trust. And the thing too is that if we've come out of a time of deep learning and we've had a huge energetic learning cycle, we often do this thing where we feel that we need to be distrustful of the process, that we have a lack of faith, that we have a lack of connection to the divine grace, right? That we have that we feel a little severed from it, that we feel a little bit isolated from it. So one of the things this new moon is trying to help us heal is that conversation with divine grace, is our connection with divine grace, to remember that it's always been there and to let ourselves have that. Rather than making it hard on ourselves, right? These are pretty intense energies, I will say. It's not, I was surprised to see these because the aspects are so great, because I get such a beautiful sense of the new moon. But here's the thing, we have our spikes up. We're a little bit paranoid. We're a little bit on edge about what this moon could bring, or what this the rest of this year could bring. If January was the way that it was, can we really trust into this? Can we really trust into this process? And these cards are speaking to that. They're speaking to that desire to maybe feel a little bit jagged, a little bit spiky. And it's okay. You're allowed to feel a little spiky. And then you're invited to relax, right? That's all we're going to say. I'm going to pull two more cards and then we're going to close this baby out because I feel really good about this stuff. Page of Swords. There's that Aquarian clarity, right? And we have Mercury here in the conversation, like I said. There's a lot of Aquarian energy, Sun, Moon, Mercury, all there. And we have this very clear directive energy, and there is Christmas and clarity, right? This is a different vibe than this work over here, because what we're doing here is we're letting that information flow through. And we're letting it show us a way. We're letting that window open where the fresh breeze blows in after being kind of in a stuffy room for a few days. And we are seeing things with a little bit of that freshness. You know, pages are so fresh, they're so but about being open to who we can become. And the Page of Swords is very much, yes, he's looking over his shoulder and he has the sword over here, so he's kind of dualistic. He's kind of looking in both directions. However, there's also this movement in his energy. Like, oh, we could go over here. Let's go do this. Let's go do this over here. Let's be this over here. There's an experimentation. There's a creativity and a curiosity that comes with him that is really beautiful. And that, if you have Page of Swords energy, that is a communicative energy. This is a communicative moon. Aquarius energy is very communicative. It has a way with words, with language, with connection. It wants to connect community, people, ideas. And that's part of this. Part of embracing your next identity has to do with we need that Aquarian energy to do so because it's a part of how we fit into the whole situation. And the Chariot popped up. Balance, heart, trust, self-mastery, commitment, connection. And finally, when I see this Chariot in this conversation, this is looking forward. You know, you look at these other energies here that we had at the beginning of the reading, a lot of this has to do with looking over our shoulders. We have these two guys looking over their shoulders. We have these people kind of looking behind them. They're resurrected from the dead. These are all kind of looking back, right? And there was a lot of looking back. There was a lot of that energy going on for a few months. Like from the Venus retrograde on, there was a lot of looking back. And this is one of those gentle, soft invitations, once again, to go from that looking back energy, that reassessing energy, to the just start looking forward. Start looking forward. Let it happen. Step into that charioteer position and don't ask how or why. Just let yourself get in the chariot. Just let yourself get in the chariot. If not for every second of every day from here on out, at least just give it this day to process through. Let yourself step into that profound, powerful energy. That's really the thing here. It doesn't have to be hard. It doesn't have to be acute. It doesn't have to be prickly. We don't have to be prickly. We don't have to be scared of what's next. It doesn't do us any good anyway. It's never stopped us from experiencing profound things. That fear has often helped us to step into heavier, deeper things. That self-trust, that self-knowing, that knowing that you have an intuitive sense of where you need to go and where you need to fantasize and daydream, let that take you with it, truly. You guys, I am wearing some of the most beautiful jewelry of my life. I'm going to show you this. This is Larimar with Moonstone in the middle, and then on sterling silver. And of course, this is from my love, my bestie, Pink Loon, Tiffany at Pink Loon. And she just also made me this Moonstone necklace or bracelet. Oh my gosh. And these are super limited. She's made a few cuffs, but they're, you know, everything she makes is one of a kind. I'm also wearing Moonstone studs. And these I highly recommend because they're just... they're amazing. So I'm wearing a ton of Moonstone right now. Like I said, everything is handmade, ethically sourced, really thought out, and just made with love by one woman who is one of my favorite people in the world, has been my rock. She's my Taurus. And I just highly recommend going and checking out her Etsy shop. because you won't be disappointed. That shop is going to be growing and morphing and changing, and there's always going to be these unique things in there. She's giving you 15% off just for being a part of my team. So go to the description box and you can check that out. I also have the Flow series up on Vimeo, the Year Aheads on Vimeo. That's all in the description box. You can find me at sarahtarot.com if you would like to put in a schedule a reading with me. I do recommend planning ahead on that. My schedule tends to be a little crazy. It's been a little crazy for me in general recently, so plan ahead if you're wanting to do that. You can also check me out on Instagram at the Sarah Tarot. I love to see you guys over there for a little bit of extras, some inspiration. There's always going to be more. You can also check out the February monthly forecasts. I do those every month as well. There's always more that we can be learning and growing from. I hope you guys really enjoy this Aquarian moon. I am so excited. Gosh, I love Aquarius season. It is just my jam. It does something very special to me. And I love you Aquarians out there. I'm just going to send another happy birthday to you all. You really are just so inspirational to me. I appreciate everything about you. I'll see you all for the next moon magic. We have more. There's always more. There's always more. There's always more growth and expansion and shift and change and release and opening. And there's always the next wave and the next wave. And I love that about life. Don't you love that about life? I'll see you guys very soon. Have a beautiful, beautiful new moon.